So the stat line of the Dark Master has been spotted flitting through the shadows of the internet, as has the price of the model. Let's talk about the new Bellicor. Hello and welcome back to Warspets Tactics, the strategy-focused 40k channel, where today we're just going over another little nugget of information about the new Bellicor model. As seems to be tradition these days, Games Workshop includes this stat line in the packaging, someone gets their hands on it early, so we get to know a little bit more about the model before we really should. I would stress though, we still don't know his points cost, which will be one of the most important things, but this gives us a far better idea as to how he'll function in-game. So from the previous previews, we already know that he has a 4+ invul, he's -1 to hit both at ranged and in melee, and he can't re-roll hits against him. On top of that, he's also a mighty -1 to wound at range, which is going to make a lot of small arms really struggle to take him out. The Sword of Shadows will ignore invuls on its higher profile, and it will double the attacks on the lower one. Now we know as well that he's got a 12-inch movement, his weapon skill and ballistic skill 2+, strength 8, toughness 7, 16 wounds, 6 attacks, leadership 9, and a 6+ armor save, though of course he will have his better invul. Like all big models, pretty much, he does degrade, his movement, strength, and attacks will suffer. But even so, with the more focused strike of the Sword of Shadows, he'll still be hitting at strength 8 with 4 attacks hitting on 2s, even when he's down to his last couple of wounds. Perhaps one of the most interesting things here is his toughness and wounds characteristics, his toughness 7, which is a big upgrade on previous, and 16 wounds, which is double the amount that he had on his previous datasheet. This doesn't surprise me much, he is enormously bigger. Just via the rules that we know, never mind anything else like special warlord traits or other powers that he might have, he's going to take around about 36 las cannon shots to bring down if they're all focused on him. That -1 to wound at range does a really good job of keeping him far safer than he normally should be. That does mean that he's really quite tough against anti-tank firepower, but he's just enormously tough against small arms fire, which usually doesn't do too badly against toughness 7 models. Things like bolters, heavy bolters, and assault cannons will only ever be wounding him on 6s, so aside from dedicated anti-tank firepower, he's largely going to be able to laugh off most shooting. Now we know he has 6 attacks, if you do go for that D3 plus 3 damage profile, he will average you around about 16 wounds to any target that he's going to be wounding on 3s. It's honestly pretty monumental, particularly seeing as this goes straight through invul saves. He's very likely to go through a Redemptor Dread, Repulsor Executioner, or any other main battle tank in a single round of combat, never mind what he'll do to a character if he gets his hands on, as most of them rely on their invul saves to keep them alive. Bellicor will be sticking his shadowy sword straight through any of that though. If he engages hordes, he gets double the amount of attacks, albeit they're at strength 8, AP minus 3, damage 1. That does still equate to him killing around about 7 or 8 orcs, guardsmen, or sisters of battle though. Of course, whether he turns out to be the next new hotness, or something that's fairly easy to deal with, will depend on his points. I'm going to guess with that decent range durability and invul ignoring shenanigans, he might be somewhere along the lines of the Nightbringer. I'd put a tentative guess of somewhere around 300 to 400 points, if I had to make a speculative guess. We also don't know his full rules as well. I'm sure he'll be able to get access to a warlord trait. I'm sure he'll be a supreme commander. And we do know that he's going to get access to his own psychic discipline in the Noctic discipline, so that should allow him even more utility on top of this. It sounds kind of likely that if he does have a Noctic discipline, that might even make him even harder to kill in one way or another. Finally, we have the slightly less great news of the price. He does cost £89 or $140. I'm afraid I wasn't yet able to find the price in euros. As seems to be the norm with Games Workshop's releases these days, it's just a little bit more than I was expecting. I was guessing that he was going to be at the same price of the Greater Demons, if not maybe a tiny bit cheaper. I still strongly suspect that he'll sell pretty well, it's a pretty beautiful model, and he will fill up a sizeable chunk of a Chaos Demons army, so at least you're getting a fair few points return for him. So let me know what you think of the new stats. I know we don't have the complete picture yet, but as soon as we have more information, I'll hopefully make another video revisiting it. I'm kind of interested to see how Games Workshop is going to release the rules, whether they will be waiting for another expansion book like a Charadon book, or whether they might do something similar to Mortarion and show us his entire datasheet and give us a points cost. In any case, if you'd like to see more like this, feel free to subscribe to Warspets Tactics, or I certainly do try and keep up with Games Workshop's releases whenever they come out. Finally, if you'd like to help support the channel, I would just like to mention that I do have a Patreon page, which you can find down in the video description. It is the thing that allows these videos to keep on coming, and there's a bunch of different benefits for members, so feel free to check that out if you'd like to. In any case, a massive thank you for listening, and I'll hope to see you guys next time.